When we talk about human evolution, the first thing that comes to mind is usually apes, especially chimpanzees. Scientific studies have proven that humans and chimpanzees are 98% genetically similar. Yes, so it is very normal that chimpanzees come to mind first, both in terms of genetics and behavior. But we should also know that in terms of evolution, the paths of chimpanzees and humans diverged completely millions of years ago. Evolution is a law of nature, but it is a very complex process with many intermediate species and various evolutionary paths. So human evolution is not something that we can simply describe in detail. In fact, if we look not millions of years ago, but only 100,000 years ago, there were 6 different human species living on the planet. Now only one of these species, Homo sapiens, has survived and is becoming more numerous. In our previous video, we talked about the formation of the Earth and its 4.5 billion year history. We briefly described the emergence of the first living things, their evolutionary processes, and the extinction of the dinosaurs, and then examined the few remaining mammal species. If you want to learn about the process up to that point, I recommend you watch that video first. Now, let's pick up where we left off and take a look at what happened from the first humans to modern humans. The primates you see here originated about 65 million years ago as an order of mammals. This group survived the extinction of the dinosaurs and evolved into various species, branching off into different branches over time. According to scientific estimates, between 6 and 7 million years ago, 2 major branches of the primate family tree parted ways between humans and chimpanzees. After this separation, humanity gradually evolved, different species emerged and spread to many parts of the world. Sahelanthropus chadensis. This species is recognized by the famous fossil called Tumai, found in CAD, and is considered one of the earliest stages of humanity. The fossils show some signs of bipedal walking and a relatively flat facial structure, making it one of the early examples of evolution towards modern humans. Sahelanthropus chadensis has the key features of a common ancestor for chimpanzee and human evolution, but scientific debate about this relationship continues. They are followed by Ardipithecus ramidus, known as the best species of the second stage. The discovery of the fossil Ardi in Ethiopia in 1994 allowed the discovery of the history and many characteristics of this species. The fossil dates to around 4.4 million years ago and shows evidence that Ardipithecus ramidus could walk on 2 legs, but it also shows a structure adapted to living in trees. These discoveries and characteristics alone have allowed science to offer new perspectives on how human evolution may have been more complex than expected, and to better understand the diversity of early hominids. About 4 to 2 million years ago. Now our species, Australopithecus, is discovering the advantages of walking on 2 legs, allowing them to move their hands freely. These acquired skills, which they will pass down from generation to generation, set them completely apart from other primate species. Australopithecus were better able to eat well, travel long distances in a short time, and defend themselves with their hands, but they still lacked tool-making skills and a special increase in intelligence. These changes began to develop in Homo habilis, a new species that would evolve after them. In fact, the word Homo habilis is Latin for skillful man. After discovering by coincidence that stones can be very good tools, they started to make cutting tools out of stones and developed their manual dexterity while making them. Thinking and using their skills to make different tools led to the development of their brains, which in turn led to an increase in their intelligence levels. In short, this stage was the beginning of the cooperation of mind and hand. Time marches on, our species began to expand and naturally spread over larger areas, which is why the human species called Homo erectus began to spread from Africa to Asia and Europe 1.9 million years ago. The spread of different human communities over large geographical areas caused each group to adapt to local conditions. These adaptation processes led to the emergence of various racial and cultural differences. For example, communities living around the equator developed dark skin color as a protective feature against intense sunlight, while communities living in the northern regions developed light skin color that needed less sunlight. Different geographical regions shaped people's dietary habits. In the hot regions of Africa, hunter-gatherer societies subsisted on a variety of plants and game. In Scandinavian regions, people ate more seafood and meat. Geographical spread led to cultural diversity among different communities. Each group developed its own social structure, language, belief system, and traditions. This has resulted in the richness of different cultures around the world today. Similarly, there are many more examples of different human species and cultures. But to summarize so as not to make the video too long, the origin of all human differences observed today can be largely explained by geographical settlement and the adaptation processes brought about by these settlements. During the Homo erectus period, humans not only spread to different regions, but also made one of their most important discoveries. They discovered fire. At first, they were puzzled by the fire caused by lightning, but gradually they learned to control it, and then they realized how delicious meat tastes after it has been cooked in the fire, that fire keeps them warm on cold evenings, and that they need to protect it so that it burns for a long time. Of course, we don't know in which way all societies discovered fire, but interestingly, all of humanity experienced it at the same period. Exactly 500,000 years ago, fire entered our lives and is now more under our control than ever before. They learned how to relight it, even if it soon went out, and began to make better tools from it, to protect themselves against savages, to light up at night, and to make better use of its other advantages. Now that they could cook meat and eat it more easily, the shape of their jaws changed, and their stomachs began to digest food better. Neanderthals. Apart from Homo sapiens, they are the best known human species in history and have a large collection of archaeological evidence. Neanderthals are thought to have emerged around 400,000 years ago and inhabited a large geographical area in Europe and Western Asia. The life stages of Homo sapiens and Neanderthals overlapped for some time, during which time there was genetic exchange between the two species. This is why Neanderthal DNA is found in the modern human genome. Compared to earlier human species, these people used more advanced tool-making techniques, were known for cave paintings and symbolic art, and even exhibited burial culture and burial behaviors. This shows that they had a complex social structure and an advanced intelligence. One of the most obvious differences with Homo sapiens was their physical strength and endurance. Neanderthals were more muscular than modern humans. In addition, their large skulls indicate that there were differences in their brain structure, and therefore their thinking may have been different from Homo sapiens. Neanderthals, who once lived in large geographical areas, ended up becoming extinct. The exact cause of this extinction remains a mystery. Some theories suggest that diseases or birth defects passed down from Homo sapiens caused the extinction of Neanderthals. However, none of these theories have been conclusively proven, and the extinction of Neanderthals remains an unsolved riddle. Finally, Homo sapiens, which represents modern man with his advanced intelligence, interest in science, art, music, and many other talents. None of the species we have mentioned so far are the direct ancestors of modern humans. Homo sapiens is a completely new species that emerged in an unspecified place about 300,000 years ago. Its name means intelligent or thinking human. Scientists are still trying to answer questions such as where exactly Homo sapiens evolved, what species it evolved from, and how it spread. Did it spread across the globe from a single center, or did it evolve independently in different places? All these questions are mysteries that have no clear answers yet. If they are answered by a new discovery, it will provide more insight into the origin of modern humans and the depths of human evolution. While other human species and Neanderthals continued to disappear, Homo sapiens managed to spread across the globe in a time span between 40 and 100,000 years. This rapid spread can be explained by Homo sapiens' ability to adapt to their environment and their complex social structure. Thanks to their advanced brain structure, they developed various strategies to survive and advance. They adapted to their environment by mastering agriculture, hunting, and gathering. These skills led them to use natural resources more efficiently. Our species was also very good at building communities and cooperating. The development of these social and cultural structures accelerated technological and intellectual progress. Skills such as tool making, fire control, and shelter construction gave Homo sapiens an advantage over other species. There was also a creative richness in areas that nourished the human spirit, such as art, music, religion, and philosophy. They became the dominant species on the planet, with their ability to adapt to and transform their environment. In the process, they transformed both nature and social structures, constantly outdoing themselves and reaching new horizons. This is how humanity has reached this point today after millions of years of evolution. We are now trying to dominate the world with a population of nearly 8 billion, but the process of evolution is still ongoing and will continue for many years to come. The question that everyone is wondering is, what will the future humanity be like? In a modern world where technology is advancing rapidly, what will the living conditions of future humans be like, and what will they look like? Perhaps technological advances, such as genetic engineering and artificial intelligence, could radically change human life. Or maybe humans will find ways to extend their lives or increase their physical abilities, overcoming their biological limitations. What do you think about this? Should our species be worried about the future, or will things get better? You can write your ideas in the comments.